Namaskar, warm greetings, and a hearty welcome to the distinguished guests, esteemed colleagues, and everyone from across the world who have joined the audience of this virtual seminar that celebrates the United Nations Day 21. I'm Tanushree Sharma, Professor and Senior Additional Registrar, OP Jindal Global University, and it is my pleasure to compare the proceedings of this seminar on implementing the Sustainable Development Goals, role of universities and civil society in protecting the environment, and the launch of the Sustainable Development Report 2021 on the OP Jindal Global University. To begin this event, it's with great delight I welcome the founding Vice Chancellor of OP Jindal Global University, Professor Dr. C. Rajkumar, whose incredible and inspiring leadership has played a key role in establishing this university as an institution of eminence. May I request Professor Rajkumar to kindly deliver his welcome address.
Thank you very much, Tanushree, and a very good evening to all of you in India, but also good afternoon to our friends in Europe and good morning to our friends in the United States. At the outset, I would like to extend a warm welcome to all of you to celebrate the United Nations Day 2021. As we know, 24th October, we celebrate this day as a part of the collective consciousness of humanity that built this institution that has withstood the test of time, albeit numerous challenges the international community has faced in the last several decades. I also want to extend a warm welcome to the seminar on implementing the Sustainable Development Goals, role of universities and civil society in protecting the environment, and of course, the launch of the Sustainable Development Report on OP Jindal Global University. Let me begin by recognizing and also appreciating the distinguished guests who have supported this initiative, Sri Dharmendra Pradhan, Honorable Union Minister of Education, Minister of Education, Government of India, Sri Bhupender Yadav, Honorable Union Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, Sri Honorable Ashwini Kumar Chaubey, the Honorable Minister of State for Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, Mr. Atul Bagai, Head of Country Office, the United Nations Environment Programme, Professor Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General of the Association of Indian Universities, Mr. Sudhir Mishra, Founder and Managing Director and Managing Partner of Trust Legal Advocates and Consultants. And of course, I also appreciate the presence of my dear colleague, Professor Sridhar Patnaik, Registrar of OP Jindal Global University. I have great pleasure in extending a warm welcome to all of you to this very special occasion. My humble and deepest gratitude to our guests of honor, all of whom who have taken time and indeed effort to support this initiative today as we mark the occasion of the United Nations Day 2021. First of all, let me extend my heartiest congratulations and deep appreciation to Mr. Sudhir Mishra, Founder and Managing Partner of Trust Legal Advocates and Consultants, for being here today and representing the entire team of 12 esteemed authors who are responsible for the Sustainable Development Report 2021 on OP Jindal Global University, which will be launched shortly later this evening. This day also marks a very important seminar that we're hosting with regard to recognizing the role of universities in promoting sustainable development and also advancing the cause of environment. After the invention of the steam engine and the subsequent onset of the Industrial Revolution in the 19th century, the 20th century witnessed unprecedented economic growth and a sharp increase in per capita income of populations around the globe. In 2021 in India, we're marking the 30th anniversary of the economic reforms that was initiated in 1991. Now, unfortunately, this rapid economic growth came at a great expense to our environment. In today's time, climate change and global warming, which are indirect consequences of the Industrial Revolution, but also challenges of the times that we're living in, are also one of the biggest challenges facing humankind as they endanger the very existence of humanity. There is no better time than this time when we are facing the global pandemic to be conscious about the global challenges to environment that we are imminently facing. While we tackle these environmental issues, nations around the world also face severe challenges surrounding poverty, hunger, inequality, and various other forms of social injustice. Unfortunately, the unprecedented crisis of the COVID-19 pandemic has only further exacerbated these issues and taken us back probably by a few years in the progress that we have made. The way forward for a sustainable future requires a fine balance between economic, social, and environmental development of the world. It is with this very vision that the 17 Sustainable Development Goals were born after a collective deliberation of nearly 193 UN member countries in 2015. Given the magnitude of the problem at hand, it is important that everyone around the world, whether individuals or institutions, embrace the very essence of the Sustainable Development Goals defined by the United Nations so that we can all do our part in shaping a sustainable future for the generations to come. While higher education institutions and universities are bound to narrow a view on the implementation of the SDG with regard to education, I strongly believe that universities have a very stronger and a more substantive role to play in advancing the cause of SDGs. At JGU, we believe that higher education institutions can play a much significant role across the entire spectrum of the implementation of sustainable development goals. It is with this spirit that OP Jindal Global University has been deeply committed to creating a green accounted and socially conscious campuses ecosystem, driving sustainability across all the 17 goals as defined by the UN. To further strengthen our commitment to these goals, earlier this year, we embarked on a new journey to assess ourselves. Hence, we engaged in a third party and independent assessment of our campus and initiatives to have a transparent and fair view of our progress in our compliance with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. We invited 12 distinguished authors and assessors representing reputed institutions, various organizations, including the Energy and Resources Institute, TERI, Mazars Business Advisors, a distinguished global auditing firm, Trust Legal Advocates and Consultants. The very fact that these authors represent such diverse backgrounds, including law, business, energy and resources, gender and social development, energy and waste management, demonstrated the holistic view of the report. The authors also included senior leadership of the assessment organizations, including managing and senior partners, directors and vice presidents, which is also a true reflection of their commitment and seriousness towards driving impact. This report entailed a very rigorous evaluation process across the last few months. This included an evaluation of our initiatives on environmental and social sustainability, as well as a legal view of the aspects of sustainability. A comprehensive assessment was conducted on our processes, ranging from energy consumption to water management systems to community engagement initiatives. Further, to ensure transparency in the assessment, an evidence-based approach was utilized. This included a legal review of 12 categories of evidences with submission of a plethora of evidence, right from a no objection certificate for the swimming pool to the environment clearance reports that need to be obtained in every aspect of university governance. The assessors also performed an evaluation of 9 different aspects of OP Jindal Global University's governance and ethical framework. The assessors also took into account our research practices, community engagement practices, leadership and governance, quality and assurance, committee-driven social practices, and the environmental friendliness of our campus. Additionally, a substantial portion of the assessment was an outcome of a site assessment done during multiple visits for significant periods of time to evaluate the actual on-ground implementation of the process. Needless to say that this assessment relied on a very careful and thorough analysis of our institution and is demonstrated by the final outcomes, which is a comprehensive report with 4 chapters and 24 sub-chapters spread across over 100 pages. I am truly grateful for the time and commitment of all the organizations involved in the report generation, including TERI, Trust Legal, Mazars, and other individual authors who have created such a robust mechanism for tracking the compliance of education institutions with the Sustainable Development Goals. I am sure that their assessment template will serve as a very important benchmark for higher education institutions across the country, and I dare say around the world. I would also like to personally thank Mr. Sudhir Mishra, who is one of the primary authors of this report and the great minds behind developing such a robust SDG compliance mechanism, who is also present here with us today. The report, I believe, is perhaps the first of its kind evaluation undertaken by higher education institutions, and it humbles me to see that OP Jindal Global University, which is one of the relatively younger universities in India, has once again taken a very important lead in making a larger impact on the world around us. There couldn't have been a more significant moment than today, which marks the United Nations Day to launch this report. I want to mention, particularly because of the fact that we have the presence of Professor Dr. Pankaj Mittal, that this is an extraordinary opportunity for the Association of Indian Universities to galvanize intellectual consciousness among the 1,000 Indian universities, the 40,000 colleges, the 1,600 law schools, and indeed the 5,000 plus business schools across India, that every institution ought to undertake a sustainable development goal report and understand and evaluate their own situation. I believe this is a very important and meaningful approach towards universities playing a far more significant role. Let me quickly identify five important roles that the universities and higher education institutions ought to play in advancing the cause of sustainable development goals. First, and the most important part of the role, is to be able to advance teaching and in many ways create knowledge with regard to the SDG itself. Universities have a fundamental responsibility to advance the cause of SDGs, and this could be done by universities taking an effort to offer programs, including degree programs, as well as other such programs. OP Jindal Global University established the Jindal School of Environment and Sustainability, and since then we have been offering a course on Bachelor of Arts in Environmental Studies. This year, I'm happy to report that we have launched a Bachelor of Arts / Bachelor of Science degree in sustainable development. This effort by the Jindal School of Environment and Sustainability is going to help us advance some of those causes. The second role of the university is to be able to create research and contribute to new ideas and thinking when it comes to sustainable development. How do we implement these goals, not just within institutions, but also other actors? Third, the universities ought to be able to provide guidance and indeed leadership towards building collaborations with other organizations, including companies, corporations, business enterprises, think tanks, research institutions, non-governmental organizations, intergovernmental organizations, to advance the cause of implementation of sustainable development goals. The fourth role that the universities can play is to connect with government agencies, to be able to work closely with ministries and departments of government, both within the state and the central government, when it comes to implementing the sustainable development goals. And the fifth is what we are doing, which is to internally assess the functioning of the universities with regard to their own responsibilities for fulfilling the sustainable development goals. And that is something that OP Jindal Global University is doing today. The fact that we demonstrated our commitment to a sustainable present and future in such a comprehensive and rigorous assessment process is indeed an outcome of the joint efforts of every member of the JGU community. My deepest gratitude to our benefactor and founding chancellor, Mr. Naveen Jindal, who has always supported our vision and goals for a sustainable future and led by example. Thus, on the occasion of the United Nations Day, let us pledge to always strengthen our commitment to the SDGs as envisaged by the UN. We must always strive to leave this world a better place for the future generations. On that note, I would like to end my speech in the words of Mr. Kofi Annan, former Secretary General of the United Nations, and I quote, "Let us be good stewards of the earth we inherited. All of us have to share the earth's fragile ecosystems and precious resources, and each of us have a role to play in preserving them. If we are to go on living together on this earth, we must all be responsible for it," unquote. With those words, let me once again extend a warm welcome to all of you to the seminar and indeed the launch of the SDR 2021 of JGU. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Rajkumar, for your welcome address. Taking the proceedings further, it is with immense pleasure I introduce the first distinguished guest of the day, Mr. Sudhir Mishra, founder and managing partner, Trust Legal, advocates and consultants. Mr. Mishra is one of the most eminent environmental, infrastructural, and oil and gas lawyers in the country. In recognition of his commendable work, he had been adjudged as the best environmental law of the year in the Legal Era Awards 2013, in collaboration with Business Standard Newspaper and CNBC TV 18. He's also a member of the International Bar Association and the New York State Bar Association. Mr. Mishra had been appointed India Coordinator and Co-Chair New Delhi of the International Section of the New York State Bar Association. He currently advises local and international clients in environmental strategies, environmental sustainability practices, and corporate strategies to oil and gas companies. His other fields of expertise include corporate litigation, healthcare laws, labor issues, and matrimonial issues. I now invite Mr. Mishra to introduce the Sustainable Development Report 2021.
Thank you, Tanushree. I am really indebted to Professor Rajkumar for having the vision to even think about doing something which I'll not call a sustainable development report. I'll actually call it an introspection report. Why I'll call it an introspection report? Because in our country, as a practicing lawyer, every time in last 20 years when I've appeared before the high courts and the Supreme Court and the National Green Tribunal, I have always heard them say that educational system has to incorporate environmental teaching. Educational system has to talk about environmentalism. Educational system has to talk about sustainability. Courts after courts have said, and I was very fortunate to go for an international visitors leadership program to America in 2005 under Ivy Fellowship under the Fulbright Act. And in that 1 month, I realized that our trip, which was with another 10 Forest Service officers who all were in the rank of Government of India secretaries, they all were taken to University of Florida and Okefenokee Wildlife Refuge. University of Florida had a collaboration with Okefenokee Wildlife Refuge only to showcase how a university can be a signature for sustainability. Now, when Professor Rajkumar actually wanted to have a sustainable development report, I had few conditions, and I said that if you want to do it, we will have to involve institute like Terry, Indian Institute of Forest Management. He said, whatever you will say, we will do. And it is not easy, Dr. Mittal, when we talk something like this, because nobody in India, unless you are dragged in a court and you are asked on affidavit that take out all your certificates, take out all your water uses, take out all your sewage uses, take out all your electricity uses and your carbon footprints. Nobody voluntary has ever done a voluntary report in India. So this report, beyond the normal thing that it has a first signature or first private university, which is so eminent, is doing it, it's also a very bold step when we are going to face Glasgow, where we may not agree on the cuts which the world expects us to take. We will keep on talking about our voluntary cuts. So we are starting as a university, JGU is starting the first step. What is the meaning of voluntary cuts? And if the Terry or Trust Legal or Majas in an exhaustive, field-oriented, community-based engagement model, that's where this report has been compiled. Let me tell you, people like Dr. Sunil Pandey, who are the people who are behind this report? Dr. Sunil Pandey is a director in Terry. He was personally at the site. He personally said, Sudhir, the kind of tree, and he's listening to this program, the kind of trees, the kind of flora and fauna the university has, we need to capture it. Because the moment a student walks into Jindal, he will know that this is the importance of sustainability. So everything is almost there. We just need to document it. So we thought to relate to that, we are just mirroring what is there in the university. Save and accept few suggestions. The report is broadly, so the Vice Chancellor was quite confident about it, that you come and do the introspection report for us. and the kind of parameters which were established to do that report, the kind of criteria which Terry had fixed up, those were not ordinary criteria. So, for example, I'll tell you about the other person who is very important in this report is Madhusudan Hanumappa. Atulji, if you are hearing this, Madhusudan Hanumappa is one of the country's most important social scientists. Why you need a social scientist? Because when big environmental impact assessments are done and they unfortunately land up in a court, whether it's an infrastructure project or a power project or a port project, the real reason is that you're not engaged with the community near your establishment. You don't know what is the meaning of the community engagement. So Madhusudan is the country specialist of that. He's almost working 18, 20 countries at any parallel time. He camped, he went to all the villages near the Jindal University, talked to the people who are affected, talked to the people who work with the university on day and night, and actually mapped that how university is engaging with them on their health facility, on their educational facility, on their social side. So Atul sir, this has never been done in this country, that you will produce all your certificates, all your uses, all your licenses, all your permissions, just to create a report which is transparent, which is not a photography report. So Madhusudan Hanumappa and Dr. Sunil Pandey were the architect. Of course, my team, because we take pride in the fact that for 20 years, whether it's filing important public interest litigation to save the air, which we are doing in Delhi, or defending companies if they land up into big issues, and we have been seeing this, that even to give a certificate of consent to operate, they take a lot of time to come out with those certificates to produce before the court. So my partner, Patil Chandok, who was spearheading this entire team, and she was also clinical about it, and we had absolutely 100% cooperation from the university, the entire team, whether the architects, the engineers, the structural engineer, people who understand flora and fauna, the retired forest officials who work with the university. And if you see the report, if it is divided in the chapters talking about occupational certificate, all the NOC, environmental clearances, governance report. When you see the environmental clearances, you also see the environmental management plan. So when you see the environmental management plan, we also realize that how much of that management plan obligations have been achieved. So this has never happened. Even in the government setup or even in the private setup, nobody has dared to do their own assessment, because if you do these kind of things, naturally you are pre-positioning your environmental strategy. So this is how we have gone about it. We have taken months to prepare this trip. I was personally part of the entire tour. We went twice. I was personally there twice. Madhusudan and Dr. Pandey and Terry team were there for a longer duration. And this report is absolutely based on data. All the data has been verified. Everybody knows that Terry, for last so many decades, what kind of a stellar reputation they have to be transparent and mirror the actual thing. So our aim would be what Professor Rajkumar partially said, that this report for university should be what we are not able to achieve in schools. That whether the government expects or the courts expects or the media expects, if a country of 1 billion people have to talk about sustainability or do the walk the talk, I think there will be Institute of Women's which will have to show that this is how you protect your flora and fauna. This is how you restrict your water uses. This is how you recycle your water. This is how you are going to have a community engagement with your nearby people. And that is the reason why this report has a huge significance. If you have a campus which runs into hundreds of acres with most of the universities I'm talking about, it will be advisable that you are not insulating the communities which are nearby. This report is the first step. Thank you, Professor Rajkumar, for this wonderful opportunity.
Thank you, Mr. Mishra, for introducing this report and letting us have some glimpses of the journey traversed for evolving this report. Many congratulations to you once again. We have now reached the much awaited segment of this event, which celebrates a new milestone of JGU, that is the launch of the first of its kind report, the Sustainable Development Report 2021 on the O.P. Jindal Global University. I would request IT team to kindly present the report launch video, please. fantastic. Congratulations, everyone, especially to all the organizations involved in this report generation. Terry, Bazaar Business Advisors Private Limited, Trust Legal, Advocates and Consultants, and all the individual authors for their contribution towards such a robust mechanism for tracking the compliance of educational institutions with the SDGs. And also a big thank you to Association of Indian Universities, our knowledge partner. Ashwini Chaubeji would join us shortly. And meanwhile, may I take this proceeding forward and introduce our next guest of honor, Mr. Atul Bagai, Head of Country Office, United Nations Environment Program. Mr. Bagai joined the UN Environment's Ozone Action Program under the Montreal Protocol as a regional officer for South Asia in 2000 and served as senior regional coordinator to build the capacity of sub-regional networks in Asia and enable them to meet the compliance targets under the Montreal Protocol. In that capacity, he spearheaded and led some innovative initiatives with the Executive Committee of the Multilateral Fund. Prior to joining UN Environment, Mr. Bagai had worked with the Government of India for 17 years in several senior positions, such as Chief of Staff to two ministers in Ministry of Finance and Ministry of External Affairs, and the federal level, and to a Chief Minister at a provincial level. He also served as the Ozone Cell Director at the Ministry of Environment and Forests. Mr. Bagai holds a postgraduate degree in history from the University of Delhi. Hearty welcome, Mr. Bagai. May I request you to kindly present the keynote address?
Thank you, Tanushree ji, and thanks especially to Professor Rajkumar ji for giving me this opportunity to talk to you today. In fact, I am very happy that you've chosen the United Nations Day for the launch of a sustainable development report. And as we were discussing before the program started, it's probably a very rare feat not only South Asia. I think I don't know of any other university in Asia and Pacific of having come up with a report like this. So from that perspective, I think it's a extremely laudable effort, and it's the way to go for not only the universities, but I think for most of the organizations, whether they are in the private sector or in the government. My greetings and regards to also, and thanks to Dr. Pankaj Mittal, who is representing and Secretary General of the Association of Indian Universities, the Honorable Ministers, Bhupendra Yadav ji, Dharmendra Pradhan ji, Ashwini Chaubey ji. My special greetings to Professor Patnaik, the Registrar of the University, and of course, Sudhir Mishra ji, for having led this amazing report today. What I'm going to talk about today is something that should interest the audience today. And I'm going to highlight certain aspects where my day will be made if I were able to convince the university and the Association of Indian Universities to collaborate with us on this humble effort that we have started and launched just about a few weeks back. Can we start our slide presentation? Can we go to the slide one, if it is possible? Next one. Yeah. So I think Professor Rajkumar very aptly mentioned, and so did Sudhir ji, about the environmental challenges that we are facing today. And I'll try to summarize that in a few slides, just to set the context as to why universities and civil society organizations should be worried and should be equal partners in this. In fact, today we are all standing at the crossroads of our civilization facing what Secretary General and our Executive Director has been terming as a triple planetary crisis. And this triple planetary crisis is the crisis of climate, the crisis of nature, and the crisis of pollution and waste. And the science is extremely clear on the impact that these crises are having on human health and on the planet. Can we go to the next? The crisis is very clearly a consequence of the economic path that we have pursued. Our economic path of resource-intensive processes, the consequent lifestyle changes due to economic growth and urbanization. And just to quote a few statistics, this has led to 60% of our ecosystem being damaged in the last few decades. We are faced with a real prospect of increase of 3 degrees Celsius in global temperature by the end of this century, especially if we continue with our emissions and production patterns and business as usual. And as you all know, since you're part of this whole process also, that we are aiming for a 1.5 degree centigrade increase and not that. And we are almost at a stage where we are doubling it in our business as usual scenario. If we do not change our consumption patterns with the increase of population, we would need to extract 140 billion tons of natural resources to satisfy our growing appetite of this population. And as someone had said, that we would need almost 2 Earths to fulfill our requirements of natural resources, and we only have 1. Can we go to the next? I'll try to speak a little bit on what is the most damaging and important crises that we are facing now of the 3 triple planetary crises which we have. 1 million of our species are at the risk of collapsing. This is a recent report of the Intergovernmental Body on Ecosystems and Biodiversity, IPBES, which came up with this startling revelation and scientific study that 1 million of our species are at the risk of collapsing. Thankfully, at this stage, they were not talking of human species being at the risk of collapsing, but the way we are going, even we would be part of that collapse, which will happen. Max? Our systems are getting degraded. What we are seeing today, the COVID-19, you've all been part of this whole COVID-19 pandemic that has hit this world. This scientific work that has been done to show that the COVID-19 pandemic has been also because of the extensive ecosystem and biodiversity loss that has occurred in the last 50 to 60 years. And these zoonotic diseases that jump from the animals to human beings is largely a result of the ecosystem losses. And that is the only reason why a decade of ecosystem restoration was agreed by the United Nations General Assembly in 2019. And this decade was launched on 5th June 2021 on the World Environment Day. And this was deliberate, bearing in mind the unsettling revelations made in landmark scientific reports about which I just mentioned, on our biodiversity, on our biosphere, on our biodiversity, on our ecosystems. Next. Certainly the ray of hope and solution has also arrived. And that was when the Global Agenda 2030 was adopted in 2015 with a universal call of action. And I was very happy to see that the basis of the whole sustainability report of the university started and emanated from this Global Agenda 2030. And for strengthening the peace and freedom, and for the planet, people, and prosperity, this agenda is very, very critical and very, very important. In January 2016, already 193 countries had signed and adopted this vision. So it's now basically an ambition that has been embraced by more or less all the nations and the whole global community of 7 billion people. And it consists, as you all know, of 17 interlinked and integrated sustainable development goals. I will not go into too much of the various details of the goals. And I was hearing with Professor Rajkumar talking about the various SDGs and how they also link up with the work that is going on in the university. But I'll move on to where are we in terms of achieving these targets? Next slide. And I would like to highlight that the COVID-19 was a setback to many of the SDG targets. It's as I said, it's a part of a growing trend of emerging zoonotic diseases. And factors that drive these diseases starts with the loss of natural habitats. But we must also remember that loss of biodiversity and ecosystem has seriously undermined our efforts on 80% of the assessed SDG targets. And that's huge, meaning we were doing very well till about 2018 and 2019 on achievement of some of these targets. But COVID-19 has made it extremely difficult to now report progress on poverty or hunger or health or water, cities and climate. So I think that a concerted action still needs to be taken during this, what is called the decade of action, to see that the SDG targets are completely met. And when I was saying why, what are the challenges we are facing, the UNEP emissions gap report, which came out last year, which reviews the difference between where the emissions are predicted to be and where they should be to avoid the worst impacts of climate change. This report shows that despite a brief dip in the carbon dioxide emissions caused by the 19 pandemic, the world is still heading for a temperature rise in excess of 3 degrees centigrade, which I mentioned. And the latest and the most recent IPCC report that came out just about a month back estimates that the world will probably reach or exceed 1.5 degrees of warming within just the next 2 decades. And there is irrefutable evidence on this. The emission gap report, which I mentioned, the latest one, 2021, is going to be launched in the next couple of days. And we are afraid that the situation is not very bright in terms of meeting our targets. And based on the latest IPCC report, the UN Secretary General has called out for immediate and fast action. And in fact, he's declared code red for humanity if we do not move away from our business as usual scenario. As the Secretary General has said, we have to make peace with nature. And this is the defining task of the 21st century. It must be the top priority for everyone, everywhere. And that's where I think CSOs and universities like Jindal University can play really a game-changing role for spearheading action which will lead to environmental mitigation. Next. So next few slides, I'll talk about why are CSOs and universities important and what they can do to help the global community in addressing the environmental loss and the environmental degradation that is taking place. Because universities are like living laboratories where research, innovation, advocacy on environmental issues really actually emanate. That's just really the starting point. In fact, I would say that the schools, the primary schools should be the starting point, but it's the universities where a lot of application is done in terms of how do we mitigate the various challenges that we are facing today, whether it's environment or economic or social. And that's why universities can play a very, very important role, because universities should be where sustainability is not just something to learn, it's something to live. And I think that's the approach OP Jindal University should be taking. And with this report that you've launched today, it's a first very important step towards that goal. Next. There is a need to revitalize the role and relationship of universities and colleges that they have with the countries they serve. And I think that connection needs to come out now very clearly from a totally sustainability point of view. There is an urgent need for higher educational institutions to take cognizance of, help in rebuilding relationships with community and aid on the vision of sustainability. And I was very happy to hear Sudhir Mishraji talking about the sustainability report, also taking into account the feedback from the communities around the university. All stakeholders must also invest in students' leadership engagement. I think that is an important area that needs to be done. Another very important area which the universities like Jindal can work on is to decarbonize higher educational establishments, because they can then act as mirrors to the community. Whether the OP Jindal University is carbon neutral, whether they are making efforts or making investments towards making themselves carbon neutral, what is the carbon footprint of the infrastructure that has been created? What is the carbon footprint of the students that are studying there? I think those are the kind of things that need to be looked at by universities to help India achieve their NDC targets. And this can only be done through expanding and developing higher education networks and partnerships. That is the key, and that is very, very important. Next. If we come closer to India and look at the statistics of educational institutions in India, meaning I believe there are 37.4 million Indian youth enrolled in higher education programs. 37.4 million youth. Now that's more than the population of a lot of European countries and a lot of other countries in the world. So that kind of workforce that we have, and we've been talking a lot, and the present government has been talking a lot of how our economy is steered by the Indian youth. And from what we understand, the higher educational initiatives on sustainability in India, they should be broadly grouped under what is the government-led efforts, certainly. That is part of the broader government effort to introduce mandatory curriculums on environmental studies, of Government of India's Green Campus Award, which AICT has constituted. That's an effort that needs to be made through the government and which is being made. But I think the most important thing would be programs implemented by CSOs and foundations. And there are many foundations and CSOs. And I think they should also steer along a path of greening the universities in a synergy with what the government is doing, but also in terms of bringing innovation and piloting of innovative technologies and innovative approaches towards that. Of course, individual and independent efforts by universities who have made their mark in the global rankings could be another great example. And today's efforts by Jindal could be certainly a huge, huge game changer. And I think we should not stop at just release of the report. We should think of efforts of how to make it available to each and every university in the country, and also handhold them in terms of how they can follow the Jindal example. And that's very important. I think the missing piece which we see in this whole effort is the whole institutional approach, which would look at university sustainability in terms of operations, curriculum design, innovation, research, and promoting youth advocacy and change in behavior among the youth. There is a need to promote learning and sharing amongst the academic institutions. Next. UNEP has been working with higher education and would like to talk about our Youth and Education Alliance, where there are almost 3,000 university members. We work in 12 networks across regions. As part of that, what I was mentioning right in the beginning, just 3 weeks back, with the help of AICT and certain other partners, we've launched the India Green University Network. And we also chair the UN Higher Educational Sustainability Initiative at a global level. So I'll just like to summarize and then close. What is this Green University Network, which I'm very keen that the Association of Indian Universities and certainly Jindal would join. Next slide. for the upcoming COP in Glasgow, as part of decarbonizing universities, UNEP has initiated a climate pledge and a plan from universities and campuses under the Race to Zero UNFCCC initiative. So far, we have commitments from over 1,045 universities from 46 countries. I may not have the figures for India right now, but this is the global figures that have been shared with me. Out of this, 200 plus universities from India have signed up and shared the planet targets to reduce carbon emissions. I can obtain the list of these 200 plus universities, and that is what I said. I do not have this detailed information right now, but 200 plus universities have signed on to this pledge. But I think more universities from India should come forward to make this commitment, because India has one of the largest higher educational infrastructure in the world. Next. This is another thing which I would like to share also with the Jindal University, and also we are trying to now make it accessible to all the universities in the country, of how UNEP is promoting sustainable lifestyle among youth. And this is something which has come out with a toolkit and guideline called the Little Book of Green Nudges on how to turn sustainability into action on campus. And if OP Jindal University can look at this and try to adopt certain behavioral changes or green nudges, it'll be a good step towards making the university carbon neutral. Currently, UNEP is rolling out a pilot phase of this to shift behavior. And from India, almost 36 colleges and 29 schools have also signed up. Next. I'll just give you some more details of the Green University Network, which was launched with support from AICT, and our lead agency here is Terry Sars. And I mean, since your global report has come from Terry, I see a natural linkage with the linking up with this India Green University Network. And the main objectives of this network is to provide a common and easily accessible platform to collaborate, network, synergize, form partnerships, and execute ideas. To create a strong supply of necessary green and environmental sustainability skills through education and action-oriented efforts, to document and build on the existing efforts, contextualize UNEP's sustainable university framework to India and Indian higher education establishments, to promote and celebrate innovation, and of course, to extend beyond institutional boundaries and thereby catalyzing more sustainable communities. Jindal University, of course, was a part of the stakeholder dialogue and the initiation of IGUN. And I would like to invite Jindal University to actively join us and, in fact, help us create more interest in campuses all over the country. And that's a big role that your university can play. Next. And I'm almost at the end. I hope I've not crossed all my time limits, but I'll just summarize in the next couple of minutes. One of the big impediments for college going to youth is the lack of green jobs, which makes all youth-led efforts temporary and short-term. So while campuses in India have started offering environmental and sustainability-related courses, takers for environmental-related courses are still less. One youth out of college market mechanism, once youth are out of the college, the market mechanism will take over. But if they have these green skills, it will be a very useful thing. And I was amazed right now as I talk, we have been running a elective course on sustainability for the National Institute of Fashion Technology in all their 17 campuses. And we just launched it last month when we started this. And I was very surprised that 900 students across the 17 NIFs took over this course, because they felt that in the textile sector, they need to understand the sustainability mechanisms. And I think that is true for all the universities, where if we can bring in the green skilling, that will be a very useful way to move forward. Next. Because there's an urgent need for these higher educational establishments to help in preparing workforce for becoming better environmental stewards and managers. Next. Finally, I would like to say that youth need to apply the knowledge gained in their campuses, not only to their professions, but within their adult roles as consumers or voters or community members and investors. Only then they will be able to become better environmental managers. And finally, I would like to congratulate you once again on the launch of your very first SDG report, and also thanking you for all for giving me an opportunity to speak today. But I just wanted to say my final line that I would not like today's webinar or my opportunity to speak to just finish here. But I would look at this talk today leading to more involvement with the O.P. Jindal University and the Association of Indian Universities to see how we can collectively come together with UNEP to make the universities in India greener. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Atul Bhagia, for a fantastic and very compelling speech. We are very delighted to have our Honorable Union Minister of State, Sri Ashwini Kumar Chaubey, Honorable Union Minister of State for Environment, at the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. It's quite extraordinary that Sri Chaubeyji is joining us, sitting in a car on his way from one part of the district in Jammu and Kashmir. So we are very, very delighted that Sri Chaubeyji has joined us. Without further ado, I'm going to request Honorable Union Minister of State to deliver his address.
Moving right along, we are delighted to have amongst us Honorable Minister of State for Environment, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, Sri Ashwini Kumar Chaubeyji.
अब सब प्रथम आप सबको नमस्कार जी, सभी को नमस्कार हमारा। मैं आज लगातार तीन दिनों से जम्मू कश्मीर के प्रवास में हूँ और माता वैष्णो देवी विश्वविद्यालय अतिथि निवास में ही मैं ठहरा था और अभी मैं वैष्णो माता का दर्शन करके और ऊपर से आया हूँ और फिर दूसरे संस्थान में कार्यक्रम के लिए जा रहा हूँ। मुझे खुशी हुई कि आपने मुझे आमंत्रित किया और ओपी जिंदल ग्लोबल विश्वविद्यालय यूनिवर्सिटी की सतत विकास रिपोर्ट, सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल का जो रिपोर्ट्स है 2020-21 का, उसका शुभारंभ हो रहा है, यह जानकर मुझे अत्यधिक प्रसन्नता हुई और इसलिए मैंने इससे जुड़ना अपने को उचित समझा। आज वहां पर जो और भी लोग जुड़े हुए हैं, मुझे जो जानकारी दी गई है आपके माध्यम से कि श्री धर्मेंद्र प्रधान जी, जो माननीय केंद्रीय शिक्षा मंत्री, शिक्षा मंत्रालय भारत सरकार, उन्होंने भी अपना वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग के द्वारा, विश्व व्यस्तता के कारण वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग के द्वारा उन्होंने अपने उद्बोधन व्यक्त किए हैं इस विषय पर, ये प्रसन्नता की बात है। हमारे पूर्व के वक्ता श्री अतुल बगई जी, जो प्रधान कार्यालय संयुक्त राष्ट्र पर्यावरण कार्यक्रम के प्रमुख है, उनका भी उद्बोधन मैंने कुछ देर सुना। हमारे साथी प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर पंकज मित्तल, महासचिव भारतीय विश्वविद्यालय संघ, श्री सुधीर कुमार मिश्रा, संस्थापक और मैनेजिंग पार्टनर ट्रस्ट लीगल, प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर सी राजकुमार, संस्थापक कुलपति ओपी जिंदल ग्लोबल यूनिवर्सिटी सोनीपत भारत सरकार, प्रोफेसर डाविरू श्रीधर पटनायक, रजिस्ट्रार ओपी जिंदल ग्लोबल यूनिवर्सिटी सोनीपत, और जो लोग वहाँ प्रत्यक्ष या परोक्ष रूप से ऑनलाइन जुड़े हुए हैं, उन सभी बंधुओं को, मीडिया के भाइयों को और सभी विशिष्ट अतिथि जन को बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं। ओपी जिंदल ग्लोबल यूनिवर्सिटी के द्वारा आयोजित इस सतत विकास लक्ष्यों को लागू करना पर्यावरण की सुरक्षा में विश्वविद्यालयों और नागरिक समाज की भूमिका पर जो यह संगोष्ठी आयोजित किया गया है उसमें मैं जुड़कर अपने आप को बहुत प्रसन्नता का अनुभव प्राप्त कर रहा हूं। मुझे भारत के प्रमुख उच्च शिक्षा संस्थानों में से एक ओपी जिंदल ग्लोबल यूनिवर्सिटी की अपनी तरह की जो पहली जो सतत्ता विकास रिपोर्ट सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल रिपोर्ट 2021 का शुभारंभ करते हुए बहुत प्रसन्नता का अनुभव प्राप्त कर रहा हूँ कि विश्वविद्यालय के द्वारा इस प्रकार की रिपोर्ट जारी किए जा रहे हैं। मैं आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री हमारे यशस्वी और मार्गदर्शन देने वाले जिन्हें पर्यावरण से बहुत ही लगाव है और जो पर्यावरण के बारे में पूरे देश ही नहीं दुनिया में जो एक अच्छा मिशन लेकर के चले हैं और भारत के साथ साथ दुनिया के ऐसे तमाम देशों के साथ सहयोग प्राप्त करके सहयोग करके और पर्यावरण को किस प्रकार से संतुलित करने में लगे हुए हैं। यहाँ जलवायु परिवर्तन और अनेक विषयों पर जो उनका अभी दुनिया के कई देशों के लोग जलवायु परिवर्तन के विषय पर अगले इस माह के अंत में अगले सप्ताह तक नवंबर के 12-13 तक ग्लासगो में मिलने वाले हैं शायद, जिसमें आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री जी का भी पूरी दुनिया के लोगों को मार्गदर्शन प्राप्त होगा और उस कार्यक्रम में मुझे भी जाने का सौभाग्य प्राप्त होगा। आज जिस विषय की ओर आपने यह गोष्ठी रखा है मुझे खुशी हो रही है कि आज मैं एक तो प्रकृति की गोद में पिछले 3 दिनों से जम्मू कश्मीर के प्रवास में और विश्वविद्यालय वैष्णो माता का जो यह विश्वविद्यालय वहां मैं निवास कर रहा था, शिक्षक प्राध्यापक सब लोगों के साथ एक अच्छे वातावरण में शाकाहारी वातावरण और प्रकृति की गोद में मैं था तो पर्यावरण के बारे में मुझे बचपन से ही प्रकृति और पर्यावरण से बहुत लगाव है और हम ये कह सकते हैं और विश्वविद्यालय के का भी छात्र जीवन से मैं सामाजिक और विद्यार्थी संगठन से अखिल भारतीय विद्यार्थी परिषद से जुड़े रहने के कारण मेरा विश्वविद्यालय के प्रति विश्वविद्यालय के और वहाँ के प्रशासकों के प्रति बराबर एक अच्छा नजरिया रहता रहा है और विश्वविद्यालय का एक बड़ा अनुभव है। मैं छात्र संघ का अध्यक्ष भी रहा हूँ, पटना विश्वविद्यालय जैसे गौरवशाली विश्वविद्यालय का 70 के दशक में, तो विश्वविद्यालय के अंदर पठन पाठन के साथ साथ वहाँ का वातावरण शैक्षणिक कैसे हो, पर्यावरण से कैसे जुड़ा हुआ रहे, यह एक महत्वपूर्ण बात है और मुझे लग रहा है कि इस विश्वविद्यालय के द्वारा जो ये काम किए जा रहे हैं वो अत्यंत गौरवशाली है। आज के दिन में जो हमारे लिए चुनौती है, तेजी से बढ़ता हुआ कार्बन का उत्सर्जन जो दुनिया के लिए एक सरदर्द बना हुआ है, देश और दुनिया के लिए एक चुनौती का विषय है, ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, जानवरों और पौधों की प्रजातियों का विलुप्त होना, साथ ही वायु गुणवत्ता में और समान गिरावट, उसके संपर्क में आने से आज हम कई पर्यावरणीय चुनौतियों का सामना कर रहे हैं। आपको मालूम होना चाहिए कि हम सभी पर्यावरणीय अराजकता के बीच अगले कुछ दशकों में और तेजी से बढ़ने की उम्मीद है, जिससे हमारे आसपास के संसाधनों में कमी आएगी। COVID-19 के वर्तमान अभूतपूर्व संकट के दौर में जो अपने आप में प्राकृतिक दुनिया पर मानवता के दीर्घकालिक हमले का परिणाम हो सकता है, मैं कह रहा था कि भारत सदियों से प्रकृति और पर्यावरण का प्रेमी रहा है। हजारों लाखों वर्षों से हमारे ऋषि मुनियों से लेकर के तमाम लोगों ने और हमारे शास्त्रों में भी पर्यावरण के अनेक वर्णन हैं। हम जानते हैं कि मनुष्य का जो यह शरीर है पंच तत्वों से निर्मित है। स्थिति जल पावक गगन समीरा पंच तत्व निर्मित यह अधम शरीर। ये पांच तत्वों से निर्मित शरीर पंच तत्व में ही विलीन हो जाता है और इसलिए हमें वह जो पंच तत्व है उनकी रक्षा करना हमारा परम कर्तव्य होता है और इसलिए पर्यावरण का संवर्धन संरक्षण ये मानव जीवन के लिए बहुत ही आवश्यक है। जो वायु जल अग्नि पृथ्वी आकाश जितने ग्रह हैं नवग्रह इन सबके प्रति हमारा जो एक आदर्श है उनकी रक्षा करना हम सबका पुनीत कर्तव्य है। इसलिए तो कहा गया है पर्यावरण के बारे में प्रकृति के बारे में प्रकृति रक्षिता रक्षिता प्रकृति की रक्षा करेंगे तो प्रकृति स्वयं आपकी रक्षा करेगी।
करेक्ट।
इसलिए पर्यावरण का रक्षा करना हमारा युग धर्म है। इस प्रकार यदि कुछ युवा व्यक्ति बदलाव ला सकते हैं तो कल्पना करें कि आज दुनिया भर में 1 अरब से भी अधिक युवाओं की आबादी सही मंच दिए जाने पर क्या कर सकती है। इसका हमें संज्ञान लेने की आवश्यकता है। इसलिए युवाओं को अस्थिरता हरित नवाचार हरित क्रांति की ओर बढ़ावा और सामाजिक प्रभाव के महत्वपूर्ण दूत बनने के लिए सलाह देकर विद्यालय भविष्य के लिए सतत विकास के इन महत्वपूर्ण भूमिकाओं को निभाने में सक्षम है। वे युवाओं को जिम्मेदार और सामाजिक रूप से जागरूक नेतृत्व में बदलने का एक मंच बन सकते हैं। इससे भी महत्वपूर्ण बात यह है कि विश्वविद्यालयों में समाज के विभिन्न हितधारक हैं, समुदाय के साथ जुड़ने की उनकी क्षमता और उनके पास मौजूद जो विश्वविद्यालय हमारे समाज का मार्गदर्शन करने में मदद कर सकते हैं और दुनिया भर में प्रभाव और बदलाव लाने के लिए एक रोल मॉडल के रूप में काम कर सकते हैं। इसमें कहीं दो मत नहीं। ओपी जिंदल ग्लोबल यूनिवर्सिटी जैसे संस्थान को देखना जो कि केवल 12 वर्ष का ही पुराना संस्थान है और सतत विकास लक्ष्यों के प्रति प्रतिबद्ध है उसको प्रदर्शित करना युवा नेतृत्व की भूमिका का एक आदर्श उदाहरण प्रस्तुत कर रहा है जो हमारे देश के भविष्य को एक आकार देने में महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभा सकता है। हम आगे जो ग्लोबल ये विश्वविद्यालय का जिस प्रकार का सोच है जो आपने अपने प्रतिवेदन में रिपोर्ट में दर्ज किया है वह बहुत ही समीचीन है। अतीत में भी जेएनयू ने शिक्षा मंत्रालय द्वारा आयोजित उच्च शिक्षण संस्थानों की स्वच्छ कैंपस रैंकिंग में शीर्ष रैंकिंग हासिल करने में हमारे पर्यावरण की रक्षा करने की अपनी प्रतिबद्धता का प्रदर्शन करने का काम किया है। इसके लिए आपको बहुत बहुत बधाई भी है और पर्यावरण के अनुकूल परिसर और शासन सुनिश्चित करने तथा सामाजिक प्रभावों को बढ़ावा देने के लिए समुदाय के साथ जुड़ाव सुनिश्चित करने में जेएनयू ने एक उदाहरण प्रस्तुत किया है। यह उस प्रकार की प्रतिबद्धता है जिसकी किसी भी प्रतिष्ठित संस्थान से अपेक्षा की जाती है। इस दृढ़ प्रतिबद्धता के लिए प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर सी राजकुमार जी जो कुलपति हैं, उनको हमारी हार्दिक बधाई है। उनके नेतृत्व में विश्वविद्यालय पठन पाठन के साथ साथ पर्यावरण को और सतत लक्ष्य को प्राप्त करने में अग्रणी भूमिका अदा कर रही है। मुझे इस रिपोर्ट के निर्माण में शामिल संगठनों के प्रयासों की भी मैं सराहना करना चाहता हूँ। पर्यावरण और सामाजिक स्थिरता के सभी पहलुओं पर सावधानी पूर्वक ध्यान दिया गया है। देखना उल्लेखनीय है कि ऊर्जा निर्मित पर्यावरण और आवास, जल प्रबंधन, अपशिष्ट प्रबंधन, सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट और सामुदायिक जुड़ाव सहित सभी महत्वपूर्ण तत्वों को ध्यान में रखा गया है। आपके रिपोर्ट में अस्थिरता के पहलुओं की पूरी कानूनी समीक्षा भी शामिल है और संस्थान के शासन और नैतिक ढांचे का विश्लेषण। प्रचारक को बधाई हूँ जिन्होंने SDG अनुपालन के इस तरह के व्यापक विश्लेषण के निर्माण में अपना महत्वपूर्ण योगदान दिया है। इसलिए अपनी बात समाप्त करने से पहले मैं एक बार फिर से सतत विकास लक्ष्यों के दर्शन के प्रति खुद को प्रतिबद्ध करने के महत्व पर प्रकाश डालना चाहता हूँ। मैं सामाजिक रूप से रूप होना चाहिए और अपने भौतिक और सामाजिक पर्यावरण, और इस तरह हमें सभी ग्रहों के भविष्य की रक्षा के लिए अपनी जिम्मेदारी को भी स्वीकार करना चाहिए, ताकि इस दुनिया को, आने वाली पीढ़ियों को एक बेहतर जगह बनाने में वो सक्षम हो सके। मैं आज के इस कार्यक्रम में आपने मुझे आमंत्रित करके हमें बोलने का अवसर दिया, इसके लिए मैं आभार भी व्यक्त करना चाहूँगा और मैं प्रत्यक्ष जुड़ने का वादा भी करता हूँ। कभी विश्वविद्यालय में जरूर आऊँगा, ताकि आपने जो यह रिपोर्ट प्रस्तुत किया है उसका साझेदारी भी मैं बनने का हमारी जो इच्छा है वो पूरा कर सकूं। मैं इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ पुनः आप सबको बधाई देते हुए, आभार व्यक्त करते हुए अपनी वाणी को विराम देना चाहूंगा। जय हिंद, जय पर्यावरण, जय भारत माता, वंदे मातरम, नमस्कार। नमस्कार जी।
राज, इफ यू परमिट, आई विल से समथिंग।
यस यस
मंत्री जी, मैं सुधीर मिश्रा हूं और मैं आपको कई वर्षों से देख रहा हूं। यह देश के लिए एक उदाहरण है कि हमारे देश में ऐसे मंत्री हैं जो इतने दुर्गम परिस्थिति में भी इतनी बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट परिचर्चा के लिए इतने संसाधन करके आप हमसे जुड़ पाए। हम इस बात को उल्लेख भी कर रहे हैं और हम इस बात से और ज्यादा जिम्मेदार बन रहे हैं कि हमारी जिम्मेदारी और बढ़ जाती है। अगर आप इसके लिए इतनी इंपॉर्टेंस दे रहे हैं तो हमारा कद इससे और बढ़ जाता है और हमारी मेहनत दुगनी होगी। हमारे वाइस चांसलर के बिहाफ में, यूनिवर्सिटी के बिहाफ में और सारे लोग जो इस प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट को बनाए हैं, मैंने आपको हेल्थ मिनिस्टर के रूप में भी आके इनवाइट किया, हमने आपका काम देखा है। आप एक ऐसे राजनेता हैं जिससे हम लोग का विश्वास और समृद्ध होता है और बढ़ता है विश्वास कि हमें जुड़ना चाहिए और काम करना चाहिए मिलकर। नमस्कार।
आई वॉन्ट टू एक्सटेंड माई हार्टिएस्ट ग्रेटिट्यूड टू यू ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर।
धन्यवाद सुनील जी।
एज वाइस चांसलर ऑफ OP जिंदल ग्लोबल यूनिवर्सिटी, मैं बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ। आप हमारे इस प्रोग्राम में शामिल हो गए और मैं ये भी कहना चाहता हूँ कि जिस तरीके से आपने आपका बात रखा, हम सब लोग इंस्पायर हो चुके हैं और मैं चाहता हूँ कि आप हमारे यूनिवर्सिटी विजिट करिए और साथ में हम मिलके सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स रिपोर्ट का जो कॉन्सेप्ट को पूरा देश में 1000 यूनिवर्सिटीज और 40,000 कॉलेज तक ये बात लेके जाएं, साथ में जो छात्रों को इसके बारे में एक सेंसिटिविटी और एक इंटीग्रेशन डेवलप करें। हमारे साथ एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंडियन यूनिवर्सिटीज के सेक्रेटरी जनरल डॉक्टर मित्तल जुड़े हुए हैं और हम लोग मिलके जो पर्यावरण के बारे में जो जिम्मेदारी लेना है, जो इंस्टीट्यूशंस और यूनिवर्सिटीज के साथ जुड़े हुए जो एकेडमिक्स रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी देना है वो हम सरकार के साथ मिलके काम करना चाह रहे हैं, और आपने आज हमारे साथ जोड़े हुए बहुत अच्छा किया और हम सब लोग इंस्पायर हुए हैं, और मैं आपको बहुत बहुत आभारी हूँ। आप इस स्थिति में गाड़ी में बैठ के एक इतना अच्छा स्पीच दिया, और थैंक यू वेरी मच ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर।
मैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद भाई, प्रधानमंत्री जी का सबका साथ सबका विकास सबका विश्वास और सबका प्रयास, बिना सबके प्रयास से ये पर्यावरण की रक्षा नहीं हो सकता। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, नमस्कार।
बिल्कुल सही कहा माननीय मंत्री जी, अपनी उपस्थिति से इस अवसर की शोभा बढ़ाने के लिए, अपना प्रेरणादायक विचारों को हमारे साथ साझा करने के लिए आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। हम आभारी हैं कि आपने अपनी व्यस्त दिनचर्या से कुछ समय निकाला और इस कार्यक्रम में सम्मिलित हुए, आपका पुनः बहुत बहुत आभार। Moving right along, ladies and gentlemen, we are happy to have amongst us eminent professor Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General, Association of Indian Universities, and it's a pleasure to introduce her to you. Professor Mittal is the second woman Secretary General of the association in its 96 years of existence. Prior to joining AIU, she had served the higher education sector, especially university education, for more than 3 decades at the apex regulator of higher education, the Universities Grant Commission of India. Professor Mittal is a Fulbright scholar and has been a topper in MSc and PhD in agricultural statistics from Indian Agricultural Research Institute, New Delhi. Please join me in welcoming Professor Mittal to the virtual dais for her address. Over to you, Professor Mittal.
Okay. Thank you, Tanushree, and thanks to Dr. Raj and Jindal Global University for inviting me for this important launch. Jindal Global University has many, many firsts to its credit, including the first private university who has become institution of eminence. And this is another first, which is added to the long list of firsts which Jindal Global University has. So my compliments to Jindal Global University for launching the sustainability report on United Nations Day. Today is a very, very important day. So my compliments for launching the report on this important day. And why it is also important is that, as you know, Mr. Atul Bagai was telling in detail about how higher education institutions can contribute in realizing the SDGs. We do realize that India is placed at 120th rank in SDG, I mean, in the implementation of SDGs in 2021. And this calls for an urgent action from all sectors of the society, including the education sector. Due to their unique position in the society, the higher education institutions have immense scope and potential to contribute towards realizing all the 17 SDGs and thereby accomplishing the 2030 agenda. I feel that rather realizing the SDGs without the involvement of higher education sector is quite an impossible task. Actually, in India, there's a lot of tacit contribution of HEIs towards realizing SDGs, but there's no data on classified efforts of HEIs on the same. In the impact ranking of Times Higher Education, which assesses the universities with reference to their contribution in realizing UN Sustainable Development Goals, only 2 public universities and 9 private universities could find place. Now, this compels us to think whether the Indian higher education institutions are responsible enough in their approach towards sustainability in delivering education. Most importantly, it makes us ponder why we are not able to tap the potential of HEIs in achieving the SDGs. This is what Mr. Atul Bagai was also talking about. So to make the Indian higher education institutions aware about their role and to re-emphasize upon them the need to take up the task of accomplishing SDGs as their prime responsibility, AIU, as a representative of more than 860 higher education institutions in India, has set out to organize all its 5 zonal conferences and national conference in 21-22 on the theme, Realizing SDGs Through HEIs. So all our six conferences, these are very important conferences. So we are having six conferences. All the six conferences will be targeted on how can HEIs contribute in realizing the SDGs. We feel that HEIs in India have displayed their potential during the COVID-19. Of course, it is a setback to realizing SDGs, but they have shown their potential during the COVID-19 crisis. And they have demonstrated their expertise and involvement in solving the crucial challenges. So why shouldn't they contribute in realizing SDGs? We are left with only one decade only, because we are already in 2021, rather less than one decade, to accomplish 2030 agenda. It is therefore a crucial step at an apt time to gear the higher education institutions to dedicate themselves to contribute significantly in accomplishing these goals. Accordingly, in the annual meet, what we'll do is that all the 17 goals will be taken up in the annual meet, but in the zonal meet, a set of four closely related SDGs will be deliberated in each of the four zonal meets. I mean, there'll be five zonal meets, so one we will be having exclusively for education, and in the rest of the four zonal meets, we'll be clubbing the four SDGs which are closely related. And I'm happy to see that Jindal Global University under the dynamic leadership is now there. He was not here earlier. Under the dynamic leadership of its ever energetic and visionary Vice Chancellor, Dr. Rajkumar, has prepared a sustainable development report 2021. I have seen so far universities doing the energy audit, but I don't think any university, what to talk about doing it, they have not even thought of it, that we can be having a sustainable development report for the individual university. So I think Jindal is the first university to accomplish this, and I don't know for how long it will remain the only university to accomplish this, but we will be working on, as an association of Indian universities, with Atul Bagai was talking about this, so we will be talking about SDGs and how the HEIs can contribute in realizing SDGs in all our five conferences. And this particular report, you know that it is on environment, and you also know that not one, but more than one, around four are very, very closely related to environment. Four SDGs are very, very closely related to environment. This is SDG 7, which relates to affordable and clean energy, SDG 13, which relates to climate action, SDG 14, which relates to life below water, and SDG 15, which relates to life on land. So all these four closely related SDGs, this will be talked about in our zonal conference, East Zonal Conference, which will be held in Tejpur University. So I will also request Mr. Atul Bagai, because we have already requested the United Nations to give one expert for each of the conferences so that they can be speaking to our higher education institutions and telling them about how to implement this. So if Mr. Atul Bagai is free, I would like to invite him for the East Zone Conference, which will be Tejpur University, so that you can actually interact with the vice chancellors on how they should move forward. So I think that will be a very, very significant step, and that will help all of us in realizing the SDGs. So my compliments once again to Jindal for this report. And I'm sure that all the higher education institutions will work together I don't say that they are not working. They are working towards realizing SDGs. But one is that they are not working in a focused approach. And second, the documentation is not there. And both are important. So I do promise to Mr. Bagai and to United Nations that at AIU, we'll be working towards implementing SDGs through HEIs. And we'll see, five steps, Dr. Raj has told that research or cooperation or collaboration and awareness. So Dr. Bagai told many things, Dr. Sudhir Mishra told so many things. So we ourselves want to take it up as an agenda that how our HEIs can contribute in realizing the SDGs. So my compliments to Jindal once again. Compliments to Dr. Raj, who is always energetic and taking up. I know he's so visionary that he can think ahead, say 10 years, 20 years ahead also. And he has come out with this report. My compliments. And thank you very much for inviting me.
Thank you so much, Professor Mittal, for sharing your insights and reflections. Thank you for accentuating the need for all the universities to come together and collectively work towards achieving the UN SDGs agenda by 2030. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we were very much looking forward to Shri Bhupendra Yadav, Honorable Union Minister of Environment, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, to join us for this occasion. Unfortunately, he is occupied with some international assignments and is unable to make it to this event. So at this time, with immense honor and pleasure, I now introduce our next distinguished guest of honor, Shri Dharmendra Pradhanji, Honorable Union Minister of Education, Ministry of Education, Government of India. Shri Dharmendra Pradhan started his political career at an early age as he became the president of the student union in Talcher College in Orissa. Serving different positions in the BJP, he was elected to the 14th Lok Sabha and was elected to the Rajya Sabha twice from Bihar and Madhya Pradesh. In 2014, he became the Minister of State, independent charge in the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. In 2019, he was appointed the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas and the Minister of Steel. Most recently, he was appointed as the Minister of Education. Ladies and gentlemen, we shall now have the special address by Shri Dharmendra Pradhanji.
Namaskar, Shri Bhupendra Yadav ji, Honorable Union Minister of Environment, Shri Atul Bagai, United Nations Environment Programme, Professor Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General, Association of Indian Universities, Professor Dr. C. Rajakumar, Founding Vice Chancellor, O.P. Jindal Global University. Other distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to all of you. I am happy to be addressing all of you virtually for the seminar on implementing the Sustainability Development Goal, role of universities and civil society in protecting the environment. I extend my congratulations to the authors and the universities and other stakeholders on the launch of the Sustainability Development Report 2021. I look forward to reading it. The launch of the report comes at an opportune moment when the world leaders, including Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi, are gearing up for the COP26 meeting at Glasgow next month. Diverse voices in the form of reports, scientific inquiry, and debates will only enrich our collective knowledge in protecting the health of the planet. From climate change to ensuring equity to social service like education, to coexisting with other species, ensuring sustainability while also ensuring economic growth, particularly in the developing world, we deal with the multiple challenges that lie before us. But in every challenge lies an opportunity, like the dire event of the COVID-19 pandemic has illustrated. It accelerated the implementation of processes that were already underway. For instance, we moved to a hybrid system of learning using all modes of transmission from satellite channels to radio to mobile phones to deliver education to students when physical classes became impossible. It is important that we create sustainable solutions to the problems we face and commit to creating a more resilient environment. I am fortunate that my portfolio gives me a chance to work with about 20% of the world's under 25 population and contribute to playing a role in the shaping their future. India has more than 264 million students in schools and 39 million in higher education. Our educational ecosystem comprises more than 150,000 schools, nearly 97,000 teachers, over 1,000 universities and 42,000 colleges. The ecosystem is undergoing a major transformation under our national education policy launched last year. The policy is fully aligned to the UN's Sustainable Development Goals and aims to nurture youth with global outlook and sensibility with capabilities that can help them face the global challenges to the 21st century. The National Education Policy 2020 is built on the foundational pillars of access, equity, quality, affordability, and accountability. This means access to high quality early childhood care to quality education for the students in the remotest corner of the country. Universities have responsibility to contribute not only to their local communities, but also to the global community. This is primarily because they have the capacity to help students develop a holistic understanding of how a wide range of local, national, and global challenges can be addressed. They help students in developing the spirit of scientific inquiry, curiosity, and entrepreneurship needed to produce concrete and innovative solutions to tackle these challenges. The role of university in the road to the sustainable development is crucial. There is perhaps no better way for universities to strengthen their commitment to confront the societal issues our generation is faced with than to adopt the framework of sustainable development goals in their pedagogy and management studies. Universities are also very instrumental in meeting the large vision of SDG for a nation, given that they are a meeting point for key stakeholders such as the government, regulators, industry, and civil society actors who play an influential role in being able to expedite the implementation of these goals. Although the SDG explicitly recognize education and research as goals, universities have a much broader role to play in the implementation of all SDG by contributing to the interdisciplinary research, innovation, leadership, teaching and learning, and sustainable infrastructure to create global awareness and solutions. Therefore, especially in the current context of what is happening around us, it becomes imperative that universities devote as much as time and resource as possible and partner with other actors to create an SDG ready to generation that remains focused on the mission to achieve sustainable development. With the ongoing transformation in the educational landscape through NEP, India stands more ready than ever before for building network with students, institutions, academia, and industry from across the world to work on shared priorities and solve some of the world's greatest challenges. My heartiest congratulations once again to every member who has contributed to making this report and to the organizers of the seminar. Thank you for having me. All the best.
We extend our heartfelt thanks to the Honorable Minister Shri Dharmendra Pradhanji for sharing with us the wealth of valuable insights and his reflective remarks. Moving on, I would now request the Registrar of OP Jindal Global University, Professor Sridhar Patnaik, to kindly deliver the concluding remarks.
Thank you very much, Professor Tanushree Sharma. Shri Dharmendra Pradhanji, Honorable Union Minister of Education, Shri Ashwini Kumar Chaubeji, Honorable Minister of State for Environment, Shri Atul Bagaiji, Head of Country Office, United Nations Environment Program, Professor Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General, Association of Indian Universities, Mr. Sudhir Mishra, Founder and Managing Partner, Trust Legal Advocates and Consultants, Professor C. Rajkumar, Founding Vice Chancellor, OP Jindal Global University, all our knowledge partners, distinguished invitees, and the audience who connected with us through virtual mode on the occasion of the commemoration of the United Nations Day and the seminar and the launch of the Sustainable Development Goals Report on OP Jindal Global University. Good evening to everyone. It is indeed an important day, and we are fortunate that the Honorable Union Minister of Education and the Honorable Minister of State for Environment have taken time out of their hectic schedules and have graced this momentous occasion. We are immensely thankful to the Honorable Union Minister of State for Environment for his remarks, and also to the Union Minister of Environment for his encouragement to the initiative. Their presence and encouragement, indeed, they reflect the importance of sustainable development and the vision of the Government of India towards implementing the Sustainable Development Goals and commitment to higher education. I would like to thank Shri Dharmendra Pradhanji, Shri Bhupendra Yadavji, and Shri Ashwini Kumar Chaubeji for their continuous support and encouragement to our initiatives. We are delighted to hear their views on the idea of sustainable development and how higher education institutions can be instrumental in adherence to and implementation of sustainable development goals. As outlined by the Union Education Minister, in July 2020, the Ministry of Education, Government of India, launched the National Education Policy 2020, aligned with the goals of 21st century education and the sustainable development goals, which allows academic institutions to innovate and set a vision to fulfill the targets of SDGs 2030. We are happy that we have taken a step in the right direction towards promoting the significance of SDGs or the sustainable development goals by progressively undertaking activities to meet the goals in consonance with the national education policy. I'm also happy to report that most recently we have opened a student chapter of the International Green Building Campus under the aegis of the Confederation of Indian Industry, in addition to all the other initiatives outlined by the Vice Chancellor. And with the launch of the SDG report on OP Jindal Global University, a very futuristic and a definite step has been taken to create a green campus. I take this opportunity to express our deep gratitude to Mr. Atul Bagai, Head of Country Office, United Nations Environment Program, for his keynote address and for sharing perspectives on sustainable development goals and the way forward for the civil society and universities, particularly in the framework of the Indian Green Universities Network. I would also like to thank Professor Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General, Association of Indian Universities, for her constant encouragement and support to the OP Jindal Global University over the years and emphasizing the task of higher education institutions to achieve the SDGs or the Sustainable Development Goals. It will be our privilege to continue to collaborate with the Association of Indian Universities in implementing its mandate. On behalf of the OP Jindal Global University, I wish to sincerely thank our knowledge partners, the Tata, the Energy and Resources Institute, TERI, the Trust Legal Advocates and Consultants, Association of Indian Universities, and Mazars for believing in our vision and mission and collaborating with us in organizing the seminar. We are also grateful to all the authors of the report, that includes Mr. Sudhir Mishra, founder and managing partner, Trust Legal, Ms. Petal Chandok, partner, Trust Legal, and Mr. Raghav Sethi, associate advocate, Trust Legal, and Dr. Sunil Pandey, who is the director, Environment and Waste Management, the Energy and Resources Institute, Mr. Pankaj Kalyani, again from the Energy and Resources Institute, and Mr. Arupendranath Malik, the Vice President, the Energy and Resources Institute, and Ms. Deeksha Gairola from the Energy and Resources Institute. We are also grateful to Mr. Siddheshwar Bhalla, who is a senior partner at Mazars, Mr. Mohit Gupta, again a partner at Mazars Business Advisors, Ms. Vidhi Malhotra, who is the Director, Governance, Risk, Resilience and Compliance with Mazars, and Mr. Madhusudan Hanumappa, one of the renowned social development specialists in the country, and Ms. Manjushri Talukdar, Gender and Social Development Specialist, for their contributions to the report and for authoring the report. They have prepared the report and also a robust mechanism to holistically evaluate activities of the OP Jindal Global University identified with the SDGs. We are also grateful to the OP Jindal Global University's Chief Engineer, the Chief Finance Officer, the Deputy Chief Finance Officer, the Chief Operating Officer, the Director, Office of Statutory Compliances and Regulations, and all the staff members and the designers and members of the Vice Chancellor's Office and the Registrar's Office who had painstakingly contributed to finalizing the report. The JGU fraternity will always be thankful to all the stakeholders who extended their support for preparing a framework for comprehensive analysis of the university's compliance with the Sustainable Development Goals. On behalf of my own self and the entire JGU community, we express our deep sense of gratitude to our benefactor and chancellor, Mr. Naveen Jindal, who always supported our vision. And we are also thankful to the vice chancellor, Professor Rajkumar, for his able leadership and commitment to the idea and functioning of the O.P. Jindal Global University, which is today ranked as the number one private university in India. In closing, I would like to say on behalf of the university that we will be committed to implementing the Sustainable Development Goals through our work and activities while reaffirming the purposes and principles of the Charter of the United Nations. Thank you all once again.
Thank you, Professor Sridhar, for your concluding remarks. And ladies and gentlemen, with this, we conclude the proceedings of the seminar on implementing the Sustainable Development Goals, role of universities and civil society in protecting the environment. Thank you once again for joining and staying with us all through the seminar. Thank you.